Hi, this is Graham from Jennings Astro. This video is a follow-up to one I made recently in which I tried out using a Schmidt-Cassegrain reducer corrector with a Maksutov telescope. And if you looked at the video, you see that I had some strange artifacts on the images that I took. Now, I've got a lot of comments about this video and lots of suggestions for what might be the source of the artifacts, whether it's because it's a reducer corrector, whether it's faulty, whether there's an internal reflection, possibly there's some issue with internal reflection inside the scope, for example, baffling. And in this video, I'm trying to see if I can investigate a little bit what is the actual root cause. So first thing I did was just quickly reproduce the problem the other night. And I just pointed the scope in this setup, exactly as you see it here, pointed it at Venus and just moved the planet, basically like a bright star, but just moved it around the field of view. And it's very easy to reproduce these arcs, these strange arcs of light that I saw originally when I photographed the Pleiades. So what I'm going to do here is what I can do. I don't particularly want to dismantle the scope unless I have to. So I'm going to look to play around with something that is in my control. That is to say, I'm going to see if there's any baffling issues on the scope that are easily corrected. So this is the experiment I'm going to do in my garage. I've put up an artificial star on a tripod at one end, and I've got the 127 at the other, and I've got the reducer and the DSLR. So everything's set up the same way as it was when I took the shots in the first video. And it doesn't seem I can focus on the star, it's probably not a great surprise, but I'm really going to just look for any signs of strange reflections that may be the same kind of thing that we saw in the first video with the nighttime shots. Okay, so this is without any flocking inside the scope. I can reproduce this arc. It's not great as a demonstration, but if I just move the scope a little bit, you can see that you get a ring of light, and maybe you shouldn't be seeing that. So now I've put a roll of flocking paper inside the primary baffle. I've just inserted it and let the tension in the paper expand it, so it's not a permanent installation. And now doing the same thing, if I move this, move the scope a little bit, simulate movement of the artificial star, whichever way you want to look at it, don't see the same arc of light on top of the defocused image as we did before. So perhaps that is a clue. I think it may be worth me trying this out at night and seeing if a primary baffle fix is actually the solution. Okay, so having put some flocking paper inside the primary baffle, I went outside, repeated my test using Planet Venus, and it made no difference whatsoever. Still lots of artifacts as the planet was close to the edge of the field of view, and also when it was in the middle, which I thought was quite interesting. So if I've ruled out the primary as the cause of the problem, the next target really is the secondary baffle. So to get to that, I've had to open up the tube, and I was a little bit worried about doing that, but I think, touch wood, it's okay to do that. There is a ring here which you unscrew on the end of the optical tube. Then there is a rubber washer, and it allows you to then take out the corrector. So here it is, it's a great big thumping lump of glass. It weighs 840 grams and certainly explains why cool down times on Maksutovs are longer than they are on Schmidt-Cassegrains. So there it is. I've marked the orientation of the corrector. I'm not really sure whether they are particularly matched when they're put together in the factory, but I've marked the angle so that hopefully I can put this one back at the same position as I took it out. So you can see there's a mirrored dot on the inside that serves as the secondary. So having a closer look at the baffle, hopefully you can see, if I just bring it up to the camera, you can see that the inside of the baffle, whilst it is black, is quite reflective. It's, I guess, a conical shape like this, but still it seems possible that this reflection is the cause of our problem. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint this carefully with some matte black paint and then see how we get on, whether that removes the artifacts or not.
So I ended up using a bit of black self-adhesive flocking paper on the inside of the secondary. And when I compare the view, just looking into the secondary when it's been covered compared to what I had before, it seems like there's a major difference in terms of reflection. So I went back outside, looked at the planet Venus again. Now I know the image is overexposed, but I don't think it matters for the purposes of the experiment. But when I moved the planet into the edges of the field of view, I saw exactly the same effect. It made no difference whatsoever. The only difference perhaps I could perceive was that when the planet was right in the middle, I didn't see any reflective sort of ring or effect around the planet, which I did see once before. So maybe that was down to the baffle. So I think I've drawn a bit of a blank here really, other than eliminating the baffle as the source of the problem. So for now, I'm going to park the investigation. If I see any other way forward, if someone lends me another one of these reducers, or I don't think it's this particular one, but if I see another way of investigating it, I'll make another video. But for now, I think I've got to conclude that it is either this particular unit, I think it's probably unlikely, or it is the fact that I'm trying to apply a correction when one isn't necessary. The reduction that this unit gives me is clearly bringing the light cone, more of the light cone, into the field of view onto the sensor of the camera, and it's revealing something that otherwise probably is hidden from the camera in its normal native focal length. So thanks for watching. Sorry I haven't been able to conclude. Hope it's been of some interest nonetheless. If you haven't subscribed to Jenham's Astro, please click the link and look out for more Astro videos like this. And thanks for watching.